of us starting out or running businesses already, we always believe that setting up a stall is what's important to successful trading, right? But there might be details you're actually missing. Let's find out tonight on The Business Show. Welcome. My name is Viola. The Newsweek world over was so eventful, and because business is influenced by culture, politics, and so much more natural happenings, the business week was eventful too. Let's now take a look at what has run the business world this week. Karamoja struggling to benefit from a rich mineral source. Kenya sends team to unlock EU mango ban. Kenya delays Uganda trip to resolve sugar milk standoff. UK announces plan to boost overseas trade. And Amazon to pay $500,000 for not sharing COVID-19 data.
In a period of 3 to 4 years from the time of planting, you are able to get back your capital that you have injected in.
The adoption of these digital platforms, adoption of these virtual platforms that have come to sort of, and of course they have just come to support the traditional ways of doing things.
The COVID-19 pandemic saw budding digital platforms and new apps. These were mostly driven because of the need to stay in touch, even though there was a requirement for social distancing to reduce on the case of the virus. And right now, we still wonder, as the Kampala Innovation Week comes up, whether these platforms will still live even after the COVID-19 is gone. Tonight, on Views from the Top, we speak to Gilbert Bulejea, who tells us the role of innovation, but also how it can be sustained.
The Kampala Innovation Week this time is focusing on telling the stories of how innovation entrepreneurship is very important in driving the economy, in creating jobs, and also enabling the digital transformation of a country like Uganda. Quite a number of words, yes, but it is intentional. Why? Because at a time when COVID hit, we looked at how not only the government, but also the private sector was looking at how we can utilize digital platforms, for instance, how we can come up with new ways of survival. I mean, we talk about innovation, it is just looking at new ways of doing things, right? So being innovative and being creative is coming up with new ways of doing things, especially when there is a challenge, a problem, that most times becomes an opportunity for entrepreneurs. So ideally what we are telling the world during this Kampala Innovation Week is, it's time for us to innovate. And when we innovate, one, we're going to create jobs. And we've seen a number of young ladies and gentlemen who have come up with what you'd call startups, but what some people normally call small businesses. But I can go ahead to explain what that how those two are different. But again, we've seen how these startups have not only helped us to overcome the challenges in life, but have created jobs or have sort of given opportunities to the youth, especially in coming up with some of the job opportunities. That is one. But two, we have seen also innovation enabling the digital transformation. How it has come about is, if we went still in the statistics that we have as Startup Uganda, we realize that most of the innovations are digital innovations, meaning that they are those that are looking at utilizing internet, utilizing technology, utilizing web platforms to sort of offer service to Ugandans, right? So when it comes to e-commerce, we've seen some people selling online. When it comes to health, we've seen some people accessing services online over either specific customized platforms or even using platforms like WhatsApp, like Twitter, like Facebook. But all these have all been linked to either technology or use of the internet or any other infrastructure that is available. So the digital transformation, the government is doing what it does by providing probably the infrastructure that we need. But again, it is through innovation, it is through entrepreneurship that we, the citizens, and especially the youth, take advantage of this infrastructure And the moment we don't have platforms that are helping us with this infrastructure, then the digital transformation of moving from the traditional ways of doing things to the digital way of doing things would not have happened if it wasn't because of innovation. And of course, the last one is about economic sustainability, which we all know that it's about how much am I earning? What is going into my pocket? We may not go into the details of the GDP and all that, but we're looking at if people are employed, they're earning. At the same time, if I'm able to sell, that means I'm earning. Eventually, the economic sustainability that we are looking at, that innovation entrepreneurship is driving, is where people are able to sell and earn money. They are able to build businesses and they are sustainable. And this will eventually lead to more of the businesses that the government can actually get taxes from. We've seen some statistics still that show that it is not the big parastatals or big companies that actually employ or pay more taxes. But there's so many small-scale businesses, there's so many young businesses that actually eventually in the next about 5-10 years we shall see them as big companies. So the economic sustainability, we see it in there's so many people who have been employed through innovation entrepreneurship, there's so many businesses that are now currently mushrooming or coming up, and these are the businesses that we think and hope that they will actually be helping the government earn some money from taxes and of course from the profits that they'll be making. All know that this may not happen in a shortest time that we would want it to happen. May not be a year, may not be 2 years, may not be 5 years. But again, we all know that for us to get somewhere, we need to start somewhere. And that's where we started as members of Startup Uganda. We know it's a long journey, but we want started with these very few steps that we have started. In the work that we do, of course, we always get questions of how and why we need to go digital, why we need to think about e-commerce, why we need to move from the traditional way of doing things to the world standard of doing things. I mean, if we all want to achieve the goals that we all look out for, if we all want to move to the level that we want to move, if we all want to get to the countries that we all admire, we all have to get to where they are, to what they are doing. So for instance, if you talk about the traditional way of doing things, of doing business, like walking into a supermarket and all that, I mean, it is awesome, it is good. But again, if you are to go into where the world is going, especially in the digital era, you realize that we are now opening up our doors to other countries. You have heard about the African Free Continental Trade Agreement that was put up. And again, this was put up because we would want to see Uganda trading with Kenya, with Rwanda, with Nigeria, with Tanzania, with Morocco. This cannot be done by walking this long distance and then you're doing business with these countries and these companies across borders. So all of this is pointing to the fact that we need to go global. And you cannot go global by having a small supermarket in anywhere around Kampala and then you want to keep serving a small community. The market for the businesses that we do here in Uganda has actually gone global. It has increased. I mean, the coffee that we sell, the tea that we sell, is no longer sold only here in Uganda, but we want to go global. The only way we can go global is by utilizing the internet. And the internet has come with quite a number of services that currently can only be taken care of by having digital platforms or by utilizing those digital platforms that are already available. Which I would want to link to, for instance, the business survival in Uganda. Ideally, you know the excitement that most of us get when you start up a business, when you start up a restaurant, start up a bar, when you start up a shop. You always think that you have the market. You have a good product, a good service. But one of the hardest things to do or to acquire is a market. Market development is one of those challenges that have affected most of the startups that we work with, or most of the companies we work with. So eventually, having an opportunity of this very huge market base across Africa, across the globe, is what you must utilize, or what you'd want to utilize with the digital platforms that already have. You'd want to sell across the market. You want to sell across the continent, and which can only be done by the digital platforms, or by going digital in a way of doing business. in one of the main opportunities that we have taken as Startup Uganda is on capacity building, and capacity building including training, including mentorship, is now focusing on how to do business. And of course, when it comes to business development support, services that are provided by Startup Uganda members across the country, the incubators, the accelerators, the co-working spaces, they are focusing on some of those main areas of business development. I mean, putting up these standards is not also going to happen in a day or in a week. We've seen most of the businesses that are doing what we would call copy and paste, right? And of course, it's not something that we would really encourage. Having seen Facebook, having seen WhatsApp, Instagram, take effect, it's not a guarantee that you have to come up with an Instagram of Uganda. So most of the businesses that had thought that going global is about copy and paste, looking at what Tesla is doing or what most of these companies are doing across the globe in well-developed countries, it's not probably what something to work here. So what we are focusing on in most of our sensitization kind of approach to innovation entrepreneurship is to, as you said, to be real, focus on the market that you serve better, that you know better. The good thing is that, for instance, in Africa, most of the challenges are close, they are the same. The problems that we have here in Uganda are close to those in Kenya, close to those in Rwanda. At least you find that the market base is more or less the same. So you may not actually go wrong when you focus on, for instance, satisfying the needs of the African market or the African continent. So ideally, it's not going to be, as I said, a smooth ride for most of our entrepreneurs. It always comes up with learning and development. We just need to understand how we can now focus on building businesses that are leveraging innovation and creativity, but at the same time, keep the traditions, keep the culture of Africans. Ideally, one of those things that drives some of the businesses here has also been culture and tradition. And that's why most people are comfortable doing, going to a shop next to a friend's shop or a supermarket that you well know, because there is this kind of closeness that you feel like you have with a friend or with a neighbor. But again, we've also seen that digital platforms can actually help you create this simulation of having someone that you talk to with platforms that they have built, like chat rooms with chatbots. All these help you have a feeling that you can have someone that you're talking to, and this is going to build sort of trust that most people want when it comes to traditional kind of doing business. And as I said, it's just a matter of time that we recognize how important digitization is in doing things, not only in business, but also in community development. As we said, we'd want to see us reaching out to more of the Ugandans, not only looking at a platform that is serving people around Kampala, the central region, but we want to see the entire of Africa, the entire of Uganda already taken up. But of course, with the basic challenges that we have to do with infrastructure like internet, like high costs of internet and electricity not being everywhere, it's a small step that we are taking, but we think in a few years we should be able to get there.
I guess the big question then is going to be how to ably handle the two platforms, trading digitally but also staying with our traditional means of doing business. The Business Show now takes a break, but we return shortly. Stay tuned.